Hello students, in this session I am going to tell you fourth chapter that is file handling. Okay, this file handling, there is two word involved, file and handling. First of all, let us see what is meant for this file, right? What is meant for a file? Okay, so here is, you may define a file. File is what? File is a sequence of byte on disk, which is where it is stored permanently, right? It is a sequence of byte stored in permanent storage, example hard disk, pen drive, etc. Okay, so this is the file. As you know very well, various informations you are storing in the form of files. Okay, so you can say that file is a collection of information, right? File is the collection of information which is stored in the permanent storage. Permanent storage, right? To retrieve it for the future use. It is stored for future use, right? And to retrieve it in future, this must be given a name that is called a file name. That you are very well familiar with this, that what is the file? File contains the informations inside it. And one thing is very well clear to you, that all the files, and you are knowing very well that all the files, file names are having extension, right? And what is the mean for this extension? Extension recognizes the type of file, what type of data the file is containing, right? Whether it is the information used for the used by the user, or information for the user, or information for the system, right? And various applications, whichever applications you will create the file, each application have their own extension, so that it is recognized that from which application this file is created, right? So this part comes when user interacts with the file. This file name and extension is useful when user extracts the file to see the informations written inside the file. Okay, so now what is the importance having here? Why you need to learn about this file? And as we know that everyone is knowing about the file, then also what is the need to explain it again, right? So this is very clear to you, that file stores the informations permanently into the disk, right? Now what is the need to create a file? What is the need to create a file? Okay, so need for a data file, you may write here, need for a data file, need for a data file. Why this file, learning file or creating file is required? First of all, to store data in organized manner. We are storing file. We need file to store data in organized manner. To store data in organized manner. Right? Data is stored in organized manner. Second point, we can say to store data permanently, as we have discussed just now to store data permanently. Okay, to access data faster, to access data faster. We will come to this point again. We will discuss like to access data faster, how the data accessing will be faster through the file. Okay, to easily modify data later on. Okay, to easily modify data later on. To easily modify data later on. Okay, to search data faster. To search data faster. Right? So now, as you know that we are dealing with the data. Okay? We are dealing with the data. Right? Whenever we start computer learning, so first thing is taught, that is the data. And after that, the second one is explained is the process. Okay? And the final is the information. Final is the information, right? Data, process, and information. Data, process, and information. And you know very well that this information and data is interchangeable, right? We have to decide that what time the data is playing the role of information and information is playing the role of data. We have already discussed about that. We have taken various examples that information, which is one time it is information, but next moment it can be the data for another information, right? While processing, you are always very well experienced for this, that information and data is interchangeable, right? So now, process is what? Process is what? Very well clear to you. In the beginning, we started with the data, process, and information, right? So process is what? Process stores the information. Process what does? Process stores the instructions. Clear? Process stores the instructions, right? So what type of instruction it contains? Instruction depend upon for what? To process, what kind of process that process is going to do, what kind of problem this process is going to solve, depend upon that process contains the instructions. But instruction is useful if you will provide data. Instruction is useful when we will provide data, because here process requires data, that is the raw facts and figures. And the data is manipulated by the process. Okay, the data is manipulated by the process, changed by the process, and after that it generates information, right? So we will come to each point here. You just note down each point we will discuss now. We will come again to this, all the points, to make it clear that why we need file, right? So we have here mentioned data, process, and information. Okay, now normally what happened, this is the process, right? Well known to you, we are providing input to the process. We provides input to the process. Clear? This input comes from what are the sources? Maybe this input is already placed in the program, right? It is a constant can be used inside the program. Only the input is written, first thing. Second one, input can be provided by the user. Okay, can be provided by the user, right? Either it is there inside the program, or we can say that input is provided by the user. Till now you have used this, you have solved various programs, you have executed various programs, you have created various programs, then you have seen that inputs either be, whenever you are running your executing your program, you are checking your program, so you are providing the constants inside to check the program, and so after that you are checking the next time you are checking the program by providing input input from outside, means from the keyboard, means from the user. If you are accepting the data from the keyboard, means user is entering. After processing of this input, once the input is processed, then at the end it generates output. Clear? One thing I would like to say, that this part is this input, this process, okay, where we supplied input, or doesn't matter, input is there inside, right? And after processing this input, when output generates, so this all three are remaining in one place, means it is remaining in the RAM, means memory, okay? It resides in the memory, all this input also, process also, and output also. Means we can say this program is holding input. Input is held by the program in any variable, and after processing those variables, the generated output is also stored in some of the variable inside the program. This will be very clear to you. Okay, notice this point, that the inputs are also stored inside the variables, and after that variables are used for the processing, and at the end output is, the generated output is also stored in the into the variables, and that resides in the program. Means you can say that program is holding input and output. Okay, and after that it's depends upon the whether it is written in the program or not, it gives the output is given to the user, okay, through the monitor or whatever way, right? So till now you have done this. Till now you have done this. You created program, you accepted the input from the user, and after processing the output, you only have written the code in the program. You have already written the code in the program to print the generated output at the end and onto the monitor by using the print statement. Okay, so now the question arises here, that as many times you will execute your program, right? So you have to, if it is constant, so it will give you the constant result, means the result will not be changed, the information, the output will not be changed, same output you will get. So that is not beneficial for us. So if you will ask the data from the user, so always user is not being seated there to provide the input. Sometimes we require input in absence of the user, instead of the user, from other sources too. We will discuss that now. So either way, your constant is defined in the form of, input is defined in the form of constant or accepted from the user. And after processing, you display to the output to the monitor. And when you will close the system, so everything, this input and output, everything will be removed, as the program is stored into the permanently stored. So it resides, program means process. But the input and output, you will not be able to see. That is not being stored there. That is not be retained by the system, because it resides in the RAM. And RAM is what? It is volatile memory. RAM is what? It is volatile memory. So anything is written in RAM, it gets removed. Anything written in the RAM, it gets removed.